Oh, hey,
I'm here. I made it.
Literally running?
No. I was clicking very fast.
And that wears you out?
Yeah. I have bad fingers, you know.
That's... is it plural? You have multiple bad fingers?
Yeah, they've been real bad.
Oh.
Oh, the esports is happening right now. I gotta turn on my esports.
Well then.
There's the esports.
I'll be streaming two.
Two streams at 160p.
That's like 320.
Half of 320, but that's okay. It's the bottom half of the screen. Okay, Sombra, I'm here.
Week 6. Northern and Western Conference playoffs. Is that what you're watching?
Well, I don't know. I just do whatever Rocket League's official Twitch is.
How it be, how it do.
I was having to describe to my roommate, like, work and stuff. Like, how paychecks work and whatnot.
That's a good enough excuse for being late?
Yeah. He's getting a paycheck, and I asked him, he showed me his pay stub. And I said, do you know what any of the information on here means? And he said, no. There's literally a column that says, like, hours, right? Like, you should at least know what that means. But he was upset because he potentially left early from work today but wasn't supposed to. But to me, it doesn't sound like that was the case. He... filled out this, like, they have to fill out these weird funky sheets, basically say I did this aisle from this time to this time, I did this aisle from this time to this time.
Huh.
And it's kind of like a time card, I guess. And he thought the lady said that he was done for the day, and so he had all this stuff filled out on a sheet and then walked up to the lady and said, okay, I was gonna leave. And she said, well, you gotta come talk to me before you leave. And so he thought that meant that he left early, but I'm like, you're right in front of her. Like, she can literally tell you not to go home or not. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you didn't leave the building and then they called you and told you. Oh, that right in the good spot. So, I really don't think our teammate already left the
fuck off.
But yeah.
So you're thinking that he isn't getting paid for some time that he actually worked?
Not at all. No, he was scared that he left early.
Ah.
And he's going to get in trouble for it.
Okay, I see.
So.
I was trying to figure out why it mattered if he left early. It's because he's worried about it. Damn it. Does he feel okay now? Did you convince him that he's in the clear?
No. Oh, hey, Angel.
Oh, hey.
I don't. He's like, I didn't know I was supposed to, like, check in with her or stuff. I'm like, well, I mean, now you do, I guess. I don't see how there's a problem here still. I really don't.
He did check in with her before he left, right?
Yeah, she has to sign off on the time card.
Oh, well then, yeah, he's fine.
Jacob be?
Horse boat toilet guard. So we just saying words now?
I think that maybe it's random equals funny.
Man, if I had known I could just say random words, I'm over here trying to string together words that are clever or make some kind of sense.
Yeah.
I've been trying too hard.
Oops. Oh god, he's got that reboot kid.
Yeah, he does. It's kind of hideous.
Get out of here, sad sheep. That's your thing,
I guess. It's actually suicide sheep, but whatever.
Yeah, I don't... Maybe he knows that and he's just saying that the sheep is sad.
Or he's just... Maybe he doesn't know it. Maybe he's just like, it's a sheep that looks sad.
It looks happy to me. But maybe he thinks it looks sad.
Maybe. I don't know.
Maybe he's an idiot. That's because you're an idiot.
Look at that. I said all yours. This guy actually went for it. And scored.
Now I'm not gonna sit here and say I'm the pinnacle of humor.
You are.
I'll say it for you. Oh, thank you.
I would say the peak, just because peak has double entendre.
Yeah. Maybe the tip. But
the climax.
But
humor.
Yeah, really.
The orgasm of humor. We'll just say it.
Oh no! It popped out. It popped out! And I'm boosted. Bobus, you really need to not be up there when I'm up there. But also, that guy was way downfield waiting for a pass.
Just wait.
But these guys, so far, in their speech,
yeah,
seem like they're...
Play against them again.
They seem like they're
already.
Yeah. They seem like they're trying real hard to be funny. Like just really trying. I don't know.
I don't even have to try. I'm just naturally not funny.
I'm just naturally bad at the game.
Yeah, we're getting stomped like right into the ground here.
I have a feeling that
one guy's not even part of their team.
I have a feeling a couple of these guys are playing much higher. You try too hard, you shake a little. Oh, you're just like physically trying too hard. Just super amped.
So, get this. Some fuckface asked Olivia to his homecoming.
Wow. Are you going to shoot him?
I might. I'll have
Good.
To buy a gun.
You'll have to buy a shoot.
So there's the obvious, like, you know, I've known her since she was a little kid, and the idea of someone taking her like a school dance makes me want to puke. But there's also the fact that she really doesn't know him. They used to be friends when they were like 5 and 6 years old. They went to the same kind of like first and second grade school, but they used to hang out when they were just wee babs, you know? And now she's 12 and he's like a year older, so he's like 13.
Holy shit, that's a huge increase in age.
And,
percentage-wise.
So, you know, a large reason why they hung out was just because, you know, my mom and his mom.
<What a steal. laughs> Well, that was dumb.
Oh man, poop!
It's your turn.
But yeah, the guy actually
buy a gun and clean it in front of him.
Slowly coming back. I do have a fake gun. I have like an airsoft gun. I can
clean that. I'd be like, this guy's insane. He's cleaning a fake gun.
Yeah.
Imagine what he could do
He's
with it.
He's just holding his fingers in a gun position. And cleaning,
and
that.
Cleaning it.
So yeah, but like they don't know each other, and like her mom, his mom is Angela. Angela lost our number, so that's why they haven't talked in like 6 years.
Wow.
And my mom, I think my mom had like started to get tired of her anyways. But she just went kind of strolling through our neighborhood looking for us, and just like happened to find our house. Let's get out of here.
Hard enough.
And is like, hey, how's it going? Been a while. And I was like, oh fuck. And yeah, so like his homecoming is coming up, and he's like, you should go, Olivia. And at first Olivia said she didn't want to go, she didn't want any part of it, and I was like, well, guess what, you're not going. that is not happening. But like Angela's been talking to my mom, and now my mom is like buying into it somehow. It's incomprehensible to me why or how, but these aren't the same guys. But I think she's managed to talk, kind of like convince Olivia that she won't have to like do any dancing or anything like that. So I guess Olivia's okay with it now, but I'm still kind of like, you just give me the slightest of like winks and you're out of there. Like, it just if you change your mind, even if it's the last second, you let me know. Even if you're like halfway through, I'll drop in like SEAL Team 6 from the roof and fucking rappel you out of there. Because it's not even this kid that like cares that much. I think
it's the mom.
It's the mom. She thinks that they're adorable together. And it's like, okay, it was kind of cute when they were six. But now they're like people, and they have feelings and shit. You can't just do this.
Yeah. And I think her safety, she'll be fine, more than likely, but.
Yeah, I mean, it's not like I think the kid's dangerous or anything. I just don't like him. I never liked him.
In general, though, a lot of these, like, dances are just, like, a fucking formality. And you awkwardly touch each other, and that's your, like, first, like, almost romantic encounter, and you're just like,
Yeah.
And you don't... I mean, I never really, like, macked or anything during a dance. Obviously, that happens, but...
I don't even think that's... gonna be a thing. Like I said, she basically doesn't know this guy. They knew each other when they were kids, like really young kids, so she like probably barely has any memories of that still. Oh, fuck. I don't like it. But then I'm not gonna be a dick and like tell her she can't go. If she wants to, it's whatever, but...
What if she marries this hunk? This hunky Adonis.
Murder
in her later life. What if this is her soulmate?
I didn't go to dances.
Yeah, I went to, I think, most of my school dances, and most of them, like, one dance, I spent the entire dance in, like, the lounge, where there was, the Olympics were on. And I was just watching the Olympics hanging out.
I must have been pretty bad if you were watching the Olympics. Holy shit.
I mean, I just kind of went to them to experience them, and they weren't really worth it. they weren't good.
Like,
there's no way in hell I would have gone. I was terrified.
It went a little too bad. And then I went to proms, right? I went to two proms and had like a nice romantic dance with the significant other, because I think I was dating people at the time. And I'll tell you, it was...
Multiple people?
Yeah. So it was a whole, class, actually.
You were dating the entire class?
Yeah. Yeah. They all had
like
their way with me.
Middle class? Everyone in the middle class? Or like upper class?
Yeah. All of them. Yeah, they mostly just sat awkwardly.
You know, I remember because pictures are taken.
Yeah, it's sitting awkwardly. Like, it doesn't help that I just don't like to dance. I think it's really lame.
I don't like
it. Oh, boy.
If I'm in my room by myself and there's a song that I like, maybe I'll dance, but that is not an activity for the rest of the world to see.
I do a goofy jig at work sometimes where I like go like this with my hands up in there. You can't see, but the stream can.
And girls love dancing. I don't get it.
It's just... biggest fan. I think partly it has to do with exercise.
Yeah.
That's a big part of it. Why would I exercise to the song if I could just listen to it? Obviously it gives people like some sort of emotional hit, but
I mean there's no doubt that like when a song that you like, it's catchy or whatever, you can feel like a groove, like, yeah, this is cool.
Yeah, I
like
that.
Dancing, like going somewhere with the purpose in mind of going to dance with other people, just like, no thank you.
I like to tap to music, right? I like to move to the rhythm by smacking my hands, but that's more of because I like rhythm in general, and I like the drums, percussion.
What is with our... is our MMR up or something? What the hell?
I almost just fucked their whole team.
Yeah, fuck dancing with people. I mean, if I get married someday, maybe I'll like take lessons just for that one night, but
yeah.
I don't think I'm... that's not for me.
I wouldn't mind doing the robot, though. I don't know what I'm doing. I'll just do some like beep.
It'd be cool to learn how to moonwalk.
Moonwalk would be neat.
It can be fun to watch people that know what they're doing dance. That can be fun. Break dancing and shit like that.
Especially those Japanese robot dancing men.
Yeah. Fun. But you know, don't do that whole bullshit of like, oh, come on, get out on the dance floor. You'll love it. Let's go. Come on.
You'll love it. No, I know I won't. Stop.
Go fuck yourself.
I like the idea of moves and things with your body that works with the song. Yeah, like pretty much anything rhythmic based. That's just like, this goes with music. I like it.
Yeah, rhythm games are great. I'm kind of worried that's what my mom is doing, is she's going to be like, no, don't worry about Olivia, you're not going to have to dance, we're not going to make you do anything, and then she's going to be like, come on, Olivia, just dance, you're here.
Just dance.
You've got your fancy dress on.
People are going to do that.
Olivia she wants to wear pants, which I think is hilarious. She's like, no.
Perfect.
They're like, we got this great dress for you, and she's like, I just want to wear pants. But apparently, this is like a half church, half school thing.
Oh.
So they're said, like, you have to wear whatever you would wear to church. I was like, well, we're not part of your church or your school, so she can wear whatever the fuck she wants.
As far as I'm concerned,
she's doing you a favor by being here. So.
I think one of the dances I went to, I didn't dress up for it. I just came in my normal clothes. Like, I didn't give a shit.
Wearing pants to dance. She can wear whatever the hell she wants.
Also, it's more comfy. Like,
yeah.
Maybe. To some people, it might not be, but.
She can go in cargo shorts if she wants to.
Sometimes you gotta let the balls breathe, you know?
So sometimes you do wear a dress when you go dancing?
No, I just like to wear a dress sometimes.
You know.
Fuck.
I am kind of interested in it. Oh, ooh. No.
I got taken out. I could take you out. That's gonna go.
I ruined it.
Second dance,
T-shirt,
I just fancy.
Knee length skirt and tennis shoes.
Perfect. Go there, I mean, have a good time.
Are they gonna fucking arrest you? Is there a fine for not following the dress code?
Some people might, you know, give you shit for it, but if you don't care about that, like I certainly didn't in high school. Oh, oops. I killed a man.
Yeah, I guess props to Olivia for being willing to try something new. And then they had this whole thing at the park where, like, he had this sign and, like, roses for her.
Oh.
And it was like,
oh.
It was like this rhyming thing of, like, be my princess and all this shit. I'm like, you fucking haven't seen her in 6 years.
I'm gonna barf.
I know. I'm not happy with this whole thing.
I exist now.
She's 12. Fuck off. Don't
hit that
door. He's dressed in like a Deadpool outfit because he's going early trick-or-treating. Oh, that's the other thing, is now I have to take him trick-or-treating as well.
Oh,
because I always take Elijah and Olivia. That's the whole reason I'm actually wearing Halloween costumes these days, is because I take the kids trick-or-treating. Oh, fuck.
You know, him saying all that is super cringy, but you know what? If they were, like, crushing on each other for a while and it was, like,
it'd
be like, alright.
It'd be cringy as fuck, but I would get it. You can tell that, like, that's not his handwriting. It's his mom's handwriting.
Fuck off. No.
And, like, there's, like, glitter and shit on this poster board that he's holding up, which he did not do that. His mom glued that on there.
Oh, boy.
So, yeah, part of it is, you know, this little girl that I've been taking care of her whole life, she's growing up and she's getting older, and it's terrifying and everything. But a part of it is just like, fuck, I hate all of this. If it was a kid I knew, and like I knew that Olivia liked him and stuff, this is just, it makes me want to hurl all of it.
A really dumb situation.
I can't believe my mom is okay with it all. She's the reason I didn't date in high school. Mrs. Dating is only for getting married. It's such a hypocrite now, all of a sudden. We have 7 saves. Nothing else. We've really sucked today.
Yeah.
I don't know where this mom was when I was a kid. I almost want mine old back right now.
Fuck off. Damn it. Front flipped and landed and didn't work.
Yeah, I'm the oldest.
They don't necessarily know what they want and stuff like that. The parents, right? They think they're raising their kid right, and then they realize in the second one they're like, I kind of wanted this out of it, actually.
To be honest, I'm kind of doing the raising at this point. In most of the aspects that matter. Ugh. It's just kind of a shitty situation all around. You know what? I'm gonna lean back, cause we're not winning anyways. I might as well be comfortable.
I'm gonna be forward. I'm gonna try to win.
Mom was like, you want to see all the pictures? We got so many pictures. I was like, fuck no. Get that out of my face.
Pictures of what? Them together before?
Yes. Yeah, in the park today. They literally met each other yesterday for the first time in like 6 years.
Is this some arranged marriage shit?
It sure feels like it. So there's that. I'm also practically falling asleep because I stayed up till like 2 o'clock in the morning.
I was up till 3.
Well, you got me beat. I guess I can't be tired now.
Yeah, you can't be tired.
It's my fault.
I was lucky enough to get up at 9 though. So.
Yeah, I got up a little earlier than that. We had trouble with the machine today, so it was a bitch of a day. Let's put it that way. They actually hung out. They hung out at the park today for like 2 hours, and then he asked her to his homecoming. There you go. They saw each other for the first time in 6 years yesterday for about 10 minutes. Oh, that was it. And then they hung out for like 2 hours, so just not happy with any of this.
It's just really dumb. Like, it's just so stupid.
And I'm really glad you guys agree, because I was beginning to think my sanity was waning. Oh, come on. No!
Bruce Wayne. Bruce Waning.
That was a good pass. Teammate, deliver.
Oh. Teammate had to shoot it right where the guy was, though. You could have taken your time there, buddy.
Apparently this kid has Tourette's. I just found that out today.
Nice.
I've never seen him have like a kind of outburst like you normally think of with Tourette's, because I know that's not entirely what Tourette's is. It's not just people saying swear words real loud.
They sometimes say regular words real loud, too.
I've never seen him have any kind of outburst or any kind of tic or anything. I haven't spent that much time around him. And, you know, I've only spent 10 minutes of 13-year-old Devin.
Well,
I don't know. Maybe it's developed in the last 6 years.
Oh, go save that.
I'm trying.
Well, is your official medical analysis then and diagnosis that he doesn't have Tourette's? That he's totally okay?
Nah, I mean, she, his mom is like apparently getting some kind of scholarship to send him to this Christian school because of his Tourette's, so I imagine there was a doctor involved at some point.
How much do they pay the doctor? As much as the scholarship.
Wearing is the rare form interesting. Well, I don't know what kind of symptoms this kid has.
The shiny form of Tourette's.
feels like maybe that's part of why she's like doing all this.
Well, petty.
Is his mom? I mean, his mom's like, well, no, he's probably not gonna do it himself, so I have to like do it for him, kind of thing. But you know, maybe if they've been hanging out for a while, that would make more sense.
Yeah.
If it was like Devin really wants to ask her, but you know, he's just too shy to do it. That's one thing. But being like, well, the only girl that's ever been your friend was that girl you met 6 years ago. Let's drive around in her neighborhood till we find her.
Yeah, let's drive around.
Do that whole thing.
It's so awkward. Yeah, well, when I do that to,
I know, right?
13-year-old girls.
12,
the cops
actually
get called. Oh, 12. Oh,
I know,
I wouldn't
right?
do it to 12. 12's pushing it, man.
Now this is making me uncomfortable. But every time I carouse in the neighborhood, people call the cops. Like, what's with this double standard? Is it because I don't have the poster board with glitter on it?
Maybe it's because you're not a mom.
He just jerked his head sometimes. Yeah, like I said, I haven't noticed any kind of tick. I haven't also been looking for it either, though. And, you know, I haven't seen him in 6 years. Saw him for like 15, 20 minutes yesterday. So, I didn't notice anything then.
There was a guy at my work that, he had like a weird tick jerk thing. I wonder if he had Tourette's. Seemed like he had autism, but you never want to ask people about that either.
I think I'm playing better leaning back.
I can no longer ask him though, because he's dead.
You could ask him.
I could try.
You're unlikely to get a sufficient response.
He died of bile duct cancer.
Yeah, I think I remember you telling me about that. Ooh, how about we just fuck this team?
I really flinked that.
73 miles an hour after it bounced off of him.
No, you spelled that wrong, Angel. It's a
Luigi board.
It's Ouija.
Have you seen Luigi board?
Yeah, I've seen that.
Oh, I think I linked it.
That's what Ouija is a way to misspell Luigi. Weegi.
Angel, have you seen Luigi board?
Fuck!
I find it endlessly entertaining.
But these guys suck. Whoever gets killed in 4 goals. Whoever can't speak. I lost that match.
You certainly lost that train of thought in sentence.
Ouija time.
Whoa! I got Maverick GXT. Is this Rocket Pass thing? Or did
that's the final one.
Oh. Oh. Well, what now?
Oh, you beat the game.
Hooray. Oh, everything is random painted items. Sick. Sick.
Made my absolute month last year, or a couple years ago. There's a lot of times in that phrase. When Vinny from Vine Sauce, that's a lot of V's, dressed for Halloween as Ouija, the origin of evil, because of the movie. That's pretty good. He likes his Ouija, especially his speed Luigi.
I think it's hilarious that people get scared of Ouija boards when they're manufactured in a factory for like Milton Bradley or
yeah,
like Hasbro or whatever.
Yeah, it's just fucking
it's like right next
board.
To Ladders and in Monopoly. It's just like a row of Ouija boards being spit out.
It's real funny to know like that people just fucking move it. Like it's just, man, Oh god, that reminds me. I gotta like.
Would you say it's funny that people move it? You're talking about how people will manipulate it with their hand.
Yeah, people like
I didn't
that's
quite hear you. That's why I was just asking for clarification.
Yeah, because that's what people do is like they just kind of move it to where they want.
There's one guy that knows, and he moves it, or she, and everybody else gets spoopied.
God, I wanna. But like some of them, they just like move it to where they think there's gonna be a, you know, a thing, right? Oh fuck, I missed the boost. So if they're like, how are you doing? And one person starts moving it to the F, other people start filling in the blanks, and they start slightly nudging it towards that direction. And so it's just all entirely in everyone's heads, and I think that's hilarious. But I want to be the person that's manipulating. So like, just like, how are you doing? And just like, penis. Like, it's just, I'm hungry, or something like that. Oh, he's hungry. Like, is he looking for souls or something? It's like, Captain Crunch.
Yeah, you could have some fun with that with people that were gullible.
Like my dad. He thinks it's demons.
Ooh.
And I was like, you know it's made by the guys who make Monopoly, right?
Yeah, you can't explain that shit.
It's a piece of cardboard.
Last year, so Vinny. Okay, that is a different paragraph.
Oh my god. Talking to the boyfriend's dead brother. You think. Oh, so it ended up being sweet? Well, that's good, because that sounds fucking horrifying. Pretending that you can talk to someone's dead loved ones is one of the scummiest things that fortune teller psychic people do. I mean, they charge for it. If this person was like providing closure in the best way he could, I can see how someone would like that. That gives me the real anger when people exploit someone's dead family members like that.
Yeah.
Wanted to give him some closure or some shit. I mean, if the person got something out of it, who am I to judge?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, if that's the way you want to do it.
Grieving is a fucking horrible thing, and anything to make that a little bit better, I'm not going to shit on. But the people that exploit that for money and like keep people hanging on, that's because that's the problem, is that a lot of people don't get closure. They think, oh, I can still talk to them, I shouldn't give up on them. I shouldn't move on, because you know they'll notice that I've moved on, and that's real shitty. Yeah. So if this was like a one-time thing to like help someone who's grieving again, I'm not gonna shit on that, but man, I was really fortunate that I didn't lose anyone close to me when I was younger.
Me too. Besides the relationship that fucked me up for the rest of my life. Oh, real!
Oh man!
Oh, it's a little too real.
We have fun on Twitch, don't we?
Yeah, oh boy! This Wednesday I'm going to my counselor. It's a good time! Oh boy!
Bye bye bye! Hit the air horn! Yay!
I sound like I'm happy, but I'm actually dying on the inside.
Aren't we all? Oh. Should have tried to probably clip that. That should be what plays at the start every time someone joins our community.
Yeah, get out of here, Boogie Tent! We won with you last time, but nope, down by one! 1 minute to go! Can't do shit.
But yeah, obviously, I told you about that person that she killed herself, and that still fucks me up today, but at least I think I was like 15 or 16-ish, so I could at least handle it somewhat on an emotional level, like I could process what I was going through. I think it's fucking just awful when young kids have to go through that shit.
Yeah.
Like that's gotta fuck you up. Roundhouse.
Oh, he bounced it.
Save us from this depressing conversation.
Oh boy. what a hit.
Alright, I mean if you think it was sweet. Killed himself only a few years ago. Okay, there's a lot of pronouns. Let me go back and fuck this match, it's already over. Last year, me and my friend with the creeper boyfriend used a Ouija board and ended up talking to the boyfriend's dead brother. I don't remember if we asked who are you or is there anything you want to say, but he responded, brother, and it was so sweet and sad.
Well, we've won one game tonight.
How old was the guy that was in tears now? Well, I guess it was only last year. Well, now I feel bad for saying Ouija boards are stupid. I didn't know you guys used one last year. Oh my god, I gotta change his car. I mean, I guess to him, it's not just a toy then. It's like... I mean, it means something to him then.
It means something to somebody. I mean, my mom thinks that if she does certain things, right, it'll make her body feel better or her stomach or whatever, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, but that's not it, Mom. Like... Like, there's no way in hell the fact that there was, like, a crumb of bread inside your food made your bowels explode. Like, yeah, you know, shit like that, like, where it's just, like, there's no way in hell.
I remember you talking about this, but I didn't think it was something as simple as, like, a crumb.
No, it's kind of stuff like that, right? Like, oh, yeah, well, I'm lactose intolerant. And I'm like, okay, well, they removed the lactose from this. Yeah, it still bothers me, though.
Oh, yeah, what? Yeah, I remember that one.
Like, but that literally makes no sense.
Ash and I talked a little bit about the Armored Skeptic ghost hunting video.
I haven't watched it.
Maybe half? Maybe, probably not quite half of it. I like hearing about how ghost hunters use tools to pick up crazy shit that can be interpreted as ghostly. But I used to fucking buy into that when I was a kid. I thought ghost hunter shows were like legit. I thought a ghost hunter was as legit as being a cop or a doctor. So that shit scared the hell out of me when I was younger. Fucking Discovery Channel. What are you doing? Why are you doing? I was there to learn about nature and shit, and you're showing me ghost hunters as a 7-year-old. But anyways, I do not believe whatsoever in spirits, ghosts, ghouls, goblins, none of that shit.
Yeah,
I think it's all made up. So I don't really get the spooky tingly like I used to when I would hear a weird noise. Nowadays, I just immediately think, yeah, I'm sure it's just the heater acting up or the wind or whatever. I don't even let my imagination run wild. I just immediately assume it's a practical thing.
If
you enjoy the spooky tingly, I'm not gonna give you a hard time for it, but I just kind of disregard that now. You still
I don't even believe out. Humans have souls.
Yeah, like, you probably get freaked out because you know, you're letting your imagination do its thing. Like, it's that's that very human response to start thinking about what it could be.
Well, so it's, you know, what is this mysterious noise in nature? Can it kill me? Like, that's...
You can't explain it.
Is there a jaguar in the bushes that wants me dead?
Yeah, or some mutant creature that us as humans should never have been able to hear about, but because we have the internet, we can.
I mean, I was talking about, like, the evolutionary reason for that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Is, like, evolutionarily, we wouldn't know what most animals are, right? We don't have explanations for stuff because we don't have the internet, so we would only know what's local to us. And if something new comes up that can hurt us, it would scare us. But we don't know if it can hurt us because we can't search on the internet.
Just like once I started assuming, once my first assumption became something practical, I stopped getting the tingly feeling.
The only thing that I get
scared
of—not to
sound like a badass, but when I turn the lights off, I only run a slightly fast up the stairs out of the dark.
Yeah. And I, you know, I'll hear like a mysterious thump, and if I can't explain it, I'm just like, really hope that's not somebody breaking into my house to kill me.
Yeah, you know, there are still plenty of practical things to be terrified of. Like loneliness. Isn't this a great stream, everybody? Crippling debt. Oh, but, we have fun here.
But like whenever there's something that's unexplained, I don't think your first response should be, I don't know what it is, therefore it's a ghost or something supernatural.
It could be the scariest thing my brain can come up with.
Well, I'm just going for like the fantasy stuff, right? Like
That's what I'm saying. Like, when you hear something, if you let your imagination pick what it could be, it's going to come up with something terrifying.
Even if it's not terrifying,
something
though,
impossible.
Like, we shouldn't be just immediately jumping to, well, I don't know what it is, therefore it's supernatural.
Oh, that's
again.
Yeah, obviously I agree with that.
Again, you know, we don't know what everything is, and. And like, that almost is basically, that's almost the, I don't know what it is, therefore it is this. That sort of reasoning. There has to be a fallacy for that. Fallacy name.
They usually call it God of the Gaps when they're talking about creationism. They say if there's a gap in scientific knowledge, that's where the God is. Like, you can't, like, maybe the Big Bang, you have all this evidence for the Big Bang, but you don't know how it started. That's where God comes in. It's like, okay. Every time there's a tiny gap in our knowledge, we're just gonna stick him in there.
Yeah.
Shove it in.
Whenever there's a gap, you just stick it in there.
You just gotta shove it in there.
That's what I do. Will I fit?
But I mean, you know, when you're...
No, what is that? Okay.
When it's like 1 in the morning and you hear something, you're not thinking like logically, like God of the Gaps kind of stuff. You're just like, oh fuck, is it a zombie with axes for arms?
Yeah.
It's, you know, ethereal. That's what always terrified me, was the concept of something that is immaterial. Like, how do I can't defend myself against it. That's what terrifies me.
Yeah.
Just shoot it fast enough and can't save it.
Because, you know, I see, like, monsters or whatever, and I think I immediately, you know, as a kid, I was like, how could I beat it? You know, what is its weakness? You know, werewolves have the silver, and vampires, you got the wooden stake and shit like that. It feels like, even if it's an overwhelming opponent, there's something you can do. But stuff like ghosts, anything that's immaterial, like, I don't even know what I'm supposed to do. I'm just scared.
It was only like last year that you stopped believing in ghosts. It was because of philosophy class.
Philosophy class will do that.
I had a stat one day when I came in. I said it was something like 50% of Americans believe in ghosts, and like a third of Americans all think that they've had a ghost experience. It was something crazy like that. Like a third of people think that they've had a ghost encounter. That's how sure they are.
When I was a kid, I thought I did, and then later in life, I literally just went. Once I, you know,
yeah,
I guess I knew better, or whatever. I was just like, I was just fucking. I was an idiot.
I was an idiot. Yeah. I can't say I have. I've been creeped out by scary sounds, but I've never thought for sure that was a ghost.
You've had a couple encounters and you still don't know how to explain them. You know, the best way that I always explain them is human brains do the darndest things.
They sure do. They like fucking with you.
The whole hearing your name, there's a crowd and you hear someone call your name, but there's absolutely no one who actually said your name in that crowd. Shit like that, like,
yeah,
brains are dumb.
Said she heard her name at the house that one time. I mean, I can't tell you what that was, but I'm sure there's a reasonable explanation for it. Cause that's the thing, though, is that everybody's got fucking phones. There's so much that is live. If there was any actual evidence of ghosts, we would have found some by now.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous to think that these like apparitions. Oh god damn it. Or who knows, maybe ghosts are just, they're technologically adept as well. They know when a camera's recording.
Or yeah, especially the ones
can't see them or something, I don't know. I guess it's technically possible, but
well, yeah,
there's just no reason to believe it. There's no evidence at all.
If it gets to a point where there's no way to like prove it, you know what I mean? Then it's not provable. With
7 billion people in the world, all having a million things that happen to them in the day, statistically, weird stuff should happen.
Yeah.
You know, like there's that story of. Of someone, they were in the back of a taxi cab, they got into a wreck, and I think the person died, and then like exactly 1 year later, the person that died, their like twin brother or something, like their sibling, was in the same exact cab with the same driver on the same street exactly 1 year later, and got into another accident, and that person died. And it's like, that's freaky as fuck. But when you've got that many people doing that many interactions, yeah, statistically weird shit like that's gonna crop up.
It's bound to happen eventually. Yeah. That's
like
how
they
it
say
is.
Like the monkeys and the typewriters. The
typewriter,
thing.
Yeah. They're gonna write Shakespeare someday.
With enough opportunities.
Fuck.
Given an infinite number of opportunities, they're gonna write Shakespeare at some point.
You know about the Library of Babel, right?
That sounds familiar.
It's a website that has like a bunch of something like 300 character strings or something like that, random ones, and it has every single random 300 character string that you could have. And so that means that everything that you've done that can be described in 300 characters exists in the Library of Babel, and also everything that you haven't done exists in the Library of Babel. Right?
This is a thought experiment.
It exists on the internet.
That's fucking nuts.
You know, it's all algorithm based, so.
God damn. So you just pull up random ones? You can just like.
You can pull up random ones. You can also search.
Huh. That's pretty nuts. Yeah, coincidences are they're interesting, but like if you take the statistics into account, you won't get freaked out by them.
Yeah, no,
like weird. The stuff about like Abraham Lincoln's secretary was named after like the guy that shot JFK, and then like JFK's secretary is named after the guy that shot Lincoln or something weird like that.
Even tiny ones.
You hear those stories about like twins that were separated at birth and then miraculously find each other like 80 years later.
There's even small coincidences, like I managed to get my neighbor's old cell phone number somehow. It's not like freaky, but it's just like, huh. They're like, yeah, we're only supposed to retire. They said we retire phone numbers after like 6 months or something like that. Or not retire, we put them back into circulation.
Right, right.
After 6 months. And it hadn't been 6 months since she last had that phone number. Like, why the fuck am I getting this number? It was like, because I saw the number and I was like, this has to be her phone number because she calls my mom all the goddamn time and I have the number memorized.
That's weird.
And sure enough, I started getting calls for her like, hey, is her name was Rhonda. Is Rhonda there? I'm like, no, but here's her number. Like, I have it.
I wonder if it was like a bug in the system and it got put back into circulation before it was supposed to.
Yeah, and I happened to get it, which is nuts.
That's the crazy part, yeah. Yeah, I've read all the coincidences between JFK and Lincoln. It is bizarre. It just the fact that they're presidents as well. Like, for two people to have all those coincidences and for them to be people important enough to notice, what that tells me is that there are a whole shitload of people that have coincidences like that, but no one ever finds out because they're not famous enough. Like, I think I remember hearing about two like twins that were separated at birth, and then when they found each other, they had both married someone with the same name, and they both had like the same number of kids. Or something like that. Oh. Basically, we just want to be party poopers to every cool, spooky thing you can imagine right here at Halloween. We just want to shit on all of it.
Yeah.
We want to take all the magic and wonder out of the world, so. Unicorns? They don't even exist. Those aren't real things.
No, Kim Jong-un found one, or Ill? I don't know which one, but one of them did. Well, no, wait, no. It turns out their scientists said it was a different mythological creature in that cave.
I wanted to say their kids had the same name, but I was like, that seems like a little too far. Maybe I shouldn't say that detail. Maybe now it'll sound fake. But yeah, I thought their kids had the same names too. I was like, what's the chances of them having a wife with the same name and kids with the same name is nuts. But again, enough statistical chances of it happening, things are gonna happen.
I used to believe people had souls until probably philosophy class.
I wonder if we'll get anything from Rocket League. You think it would pop up, don't you?
Yeah, it would pop up. Plus, you would get a message. You'd get a private message.
Well, let me look at my privates. I got one.
Well, it'd pop up on the bottom of your screen, too. But, yeah, I used to believe in souls, and then I'm just like, why would souls exist, though? Like, after philosophy class, he explained it. I was like, yeah, fucking... Why would they exist? They're just like ghosts, right? They're a thing that can, for some reason, interact with the physical world, and my personality can interact with it, but it can't interact with anything else but my body?
Yeah, Andrew's got a good point. It's exactly what I was going to say, is that consciousness, and again, don't go with God of the Gaps, but consciousness is just such a big mystery. It's like, it's such a fucking weird concept that science can't explain right now.
Yeah, consciousness is crazy, but you know, I'm not going to explain it that there's a literal ghost living inside
our
bodies.
The reason we're scared of shit that like our own culture has come up with to spook us. You know, it's clearly that was something that someone came up with, wrote it down, and then we're still talking about it now because people latch onto it. I'm sure there's a bunch of other creepy, weird explanations. Mystical explanations for consciousness that people have come up with that everyone's just forgotten about. And it's like this particular one has caught on.
Yeah, potentially. And like, I
mean, if you want to call whatever powers consciousness, if you want to call that a soul, fine.
But yeah, yeah.
I start ascribing properties like it lives on and it goes somewhere or it stays here. I mean, there's just no evidence for it, so. I don't know why you would.
Plus, like, so much, like, every single medical field and stuff like that, science field, points towards, like, your body is because of your brain, not because of this thing that's floating in there. Because, like, they can poke parts of your brain, and you will have a response, right? You will do a response, or you'll have a lack of a response. Or if you get into a car accident and hit your head real bad in one spot, you can change your personality drastically.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
So, like, if your personality was in your soul, like...
Someone asked on one of the podcast debates I listened to, there was like, you're 100%, not even 99.9, you're 100% sure God exists, right? I was like, oh, of course. It was like, without a doubt, you know that God exists. He's like, yeah. He's like, so what happens if you lose a piece of your brain in a surgery or an accident, whatever, and then suddenly you're not convinced anymore? Like, what happens then? What does God do if you stopped believing because of like a physical thing that happened with your brain? It's like, how do you explain that? And of course, no one can explain that, because it's all just, you know, making shit up at this point. But as a thought experiment, like, how would a God treat that then?
Yeah.
Like, what do you do when, we're dangerously close to the free will topic now, you know, about your brain making decisions before you're even aware of them. And what does that mean? Are those unconscious choices really you? You know, memory is incredibly fallible. And I would say your memory is probably the biggest pillar in what makes you who you are. Your personality is huge, but without your memories, like, your memories dictate what kind of personality you're gonna have.
Yeah, and like, people like to use your soul as like an explanation, or not an explanation, but it makes them feel special, right? Because like, I'm my soul, right? So if you remove the soul from people, they sometimes don't feel important anymore.
Yeah, and then there's the terror of welcoming the darkness when you die, and wanting that there's gonna be more. Which I admit was very comforting back in the day, when I thought for sure that I was gonna have eternal happiness. I mean, just imagine how nice that sounds. You know, it's hard to let go of that.
It sounds terrifying to me now.
It depends on whose description of heaven you get.
Yeah. But like, it's like, it doesn't really take, for me, it doesn't take away the specialness of the individual if they don't have a soul. Because it's just like, I'm me because of my brain. That doesn't make me any less me if I just describe it as something different.
Well, it does mean that if something happens to your brain and your personality changes, you are different now. Like, it's still you, but the person that is you is different.
Yeah.
It's definitely an interesting question. Are you or your personality, but if you're an accident and your personality changes, are you still you? That's we beat you to the punch by like 10 seconds. Yeah, so I would argue that, you know, we should still call you by the same name, obviously. But no, you're a different person. If Ashton comes in tomorrow and he's being a real dickbag, I'm just gonna be like, all right, well, never mind. This isn't the person I was friends with. God, I'm getting crushed.
You're getting crushed real hard. I'm not gonna forfeit.
It's a horrifying thought. I'm so glad we're bringing this up. Now we're getting into the scary shit. Forget ghosts and ghouls and goblins. We're getting into the really existential crisis territory here.
I'm more scared of it happening to somebody else than I am to me.
Because, yeah, I mean, you wouldn't really.
You potentially wouldn't realize it, or, I think it's more terrifying to me if other people forget me.
Yeah.
Rather than if I forget other people. Again, you know, if I forget, I don't know.
There was a cool episode of House where this lady like loses her memory, And she's got like a wife and kids and a happy family and life and everything, but suddenly she's, you know, terrified because she doesn't recognize this guy, and he's in the hospital with her, like, you know, trying to give her a hug and a kiss and everything, and she's like, who the fuck is this guy that just thinks he can come up and... Wow, I scored that. And it's like, oh my god, how awkward would that be if someone feels like they've got this huge, deep bond with you, and you're just like, stop touching me, stop, I don't know these kids, I don't know any of this.
Yeah.
And it actually did have a heartwarming, whoops, it had a heartwarming ending, because the guy was like starting to push her away, and is like, this isn't the person I know anymore, and is this gonna, how can our marriage work? It had a kind of a heartwarming ending, because House pulled him to basically start dating her again. He's like, you gotta stop treating her like you've already conquered and this is your wife. You have to treat it like this is someone you have to woo again. And like, it was actually kind of sweet how
fuck
they, it was like they were getting a fresh chance to fall in love. It was kind of a nice ending for something that's goddamn terrifying. So, I mean, if I forgot everything since I'd known you, I think you and I would still become fast friends as long as I actually showed up.
And you had the same personality, and you still have the capability to remember.
Oh yeah,
I'm
just saying, like, if I was reset, same exact person, but just forgot everything, like we haven't changed a whole lot since our first game.
Yeah.
God, I was with hanging out with No Name at the time.
Yeah, that guy.
And I was saying just a bunch of silly shit in the chat. And you were like, I like you guys. You guys are pretty cool. Then I backed out of the game. I was like, oh shit, I should have said something to that guy. He seemed kind of nice. Oh well. And then we just happened to match up again like 3 or 4 games later.
I only remember like the first time. I don't remember like 3 or 4 games later.
Cause I didn't know, I couldn't remember what your name was, and I didn't know about the recently played with feature on Steam.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I was like, oh well, I probably would have sent that guy a friend request, but oh well, I guess I'll never see him again. And then you invited me to the TeamSpeak, not too long after that.
Yeah.
I had that shitty, like, $30 Logitech mic back then.
I don't even remember the second time. I'm already less of a person.
Oh, God.
No. I'm already...
Or maybe there wasn't a second time. Maybe my memory's fucked. That's the scary thing, is that, like, you can absolutely plant false memories. It's not just forgetting things. You can remember things that didn't actually happen. That's how bad our memories are.
Yeah, you can plant your own false memories. You can convince yourself,
yeah,
if you want, of something that is false. You can lie to yourself so much that you can convince yourself of something false. Like,
thanks a lot, brain. Fucking traitor. I'm still technically friends with No Name on Steam, but I was more than happy to find a new crowd.
I mean, No Name was neat and all, but he... You take the shot.
Man, our whole side's lit up. I did join a different TeamSpeak before yours. I told you about that, those guys that would just use the N-word liberally.
Oh, yeah.
And just so many edgy jokes that they thought were funny, like, not unironically. They, like, actually thought edgy was funny. And I just got real sick of that shit. To the point where I actually deleted TeamSpeak off my computer. I was like, well, never mind. I tried. I tried to make friends online. It didn't work. They were awful.
Oh, I was really trying to shoot that towards the middle when it rolled off the top.
And, And then Justin joined, and I had no idea who that guy was at the time. He was, he wasn't as good back then. I remember, we used to play doubles without you, and we used to kick so much ass, and he was like, "Oh man, we work really well together, you're really good." I was kind of, in my estimation, is equal or maybe even slightly better at Rocket League at the time, and we worked really well as a team. Now I'm nothing but a dead weight.
Yeah, he started playing a lot more.
Sure did.
with other people. That didn't help.
And it fucking blew my mind that you guys played Elite. I was like, God, I love that game. I can't believe they also play that game.
Go in. Yeah, I convinced him to play Elite. I was playing it, and he'll play this. He'll like it.
How many times are you going to score for me?
The whole not remembering who your kids are, that's almost like... I'm like, you know, not remembering who your husband is or whatever, like just all of a sudden being like, I don't know who you are. That reminds me of... like a more mild dribble it. God. Dribble it, buddy. That makes sense.
It's so bad. I kind of liked it.
Look at this. Yeah. Fucking what do you think you were going to do with that?
It's so perfect. Just right in there, and now we're tied again.
But like it reminds me of a mild form of, you know, I don't have that. I'm an idiot. it reminds me of a time where, like, there was this guy from elementary school that I saw him for the first time in years. And I was like, holy shit, like, you were in my Cub Scouts, like, for a little bit. There was that time where we went to this, like, I forget, one place together. I don't remember now. I was like, remember that shit? And he's like, I don't remember who you are at all. And I'm like, really? Like, and it is the guy. Like, yeah, I know it is. Especially because I was like, I told my parents too. I'm like, hey, remember this kid? And they're like, yeah, I remember him. I'm like, yeah, he doesn't remember me.
If I met Dustin Comstock in a store one day and he didn't remember me, I would probably start crying. We were the bestest of pals until like I think like third grade ish the last time I saw him, third or fourth grade. We were such good buddies. We used to play Pokemon, and I would always be Charmander. For some reason we could only be one of the starters. There were three of us that hung out, and we would always pick one of the... We'd have to be Squirtle, Charmander. I don't know why.
You'd have to be for what, though? Hold on. What are you being it
we
for?
We just pretended to be Pokemon. It was first grade. I would do it.
No, I get it.
I would still do that.
Sometimes I think I'm a Team Rocket Meow. I imitate that. Just do his normal speak.
Oh, that's why I'm scared, Angel.
Wow, that one guy left.
Shit. If Dustin didn't want to talk to me, it'd be too much for poor Sunbro to handle. You played Zoids? Aww.
There's this guy named John for me.
Damn it. Zoids was cool.
I be on the own goal.
Ooh, I got a painted cloudburst. Cool.
I wasn't mad at teammate for that. I was more of just shocked at the, just. What would be the word? At his decision making in that certain situation, I guess. Just absolutely baffled. Not like, fuck you, I hate you. Did you play it? Oh, you. Angel. Zoids, you say? I'm almost done with the Zoids.
I'm interested in that one as well. I loved playing Star Fox on the swings. We would be, you know, like, I was usually Falco because obviously I was Falco.
Yeah.
And for some goddamn reason, we would always be like, we would always culminate in us ejecting at the end. We'd have to, and we would just fling out of the swing at the highest point in the arc and just go flying off. It was real stupid, real good way to get hurt, but we'd always did that. We were always getting shot down. I can't shake him, and like swinging left and right. Shit, I would do that now. That sounds like fun. I probably wouldn't do the I gotta eject part and fling myself off as.
I would swing. The swinging's fun.
Swinging is great. Why can't people get together and do swinging instead of
I mean they do. Oh.
Where's that website? But no, I was going to say instead of like a school dance, why don't we have a school swing? Let's all just get together and do some swings.
Well, you could do swinging by yourself, and you could call it swingles.
Swingles. What did I say? Why can't everyone just get together and swing? Oh man.
Swingles, yeah, that's the... Yeah, swingles, I think, is like a... Do you want a fucking... maybe it's a... It might be a fictional. It's... Either the fictional or the real one was about, like, hey, you know, do you want to get together with a... I think it was, like, a couple. Or, no, it was just, like, do you want to just fuck, basically. It's like, you just want to go around and just, like...
Oh man, how about that Ashley Madison website that got hacked?
Oh yeah,
that was nuts. You shouldn't cheat on people. That's one of the shittiest things a human being can do. But oh my god, those guys must have been shitting themselves when they read
that. Yeah.
Can you imagine? Oh my god.
I heard that there was a guy that potentially like killed himself after it too.
You gotta, I guess you just gotta pray that your wife doesn't like go investigate what names are on the, that were like leaked or whatever.
Yeah.
Jeez. Of course I say wife, like guys are the only ones that cheat. Yeah, I'm sure there were a lot of divorces. Oh my god, maybe the guy that leaked it was a divorce attorney.
Divorce attorney / hackmaster.
Hackman. I should have had that. Can you imagine cheating on someone? Can you imagine two people wanting to have sex with you? It's nuts.
Can you imagine one person? My god.
I mean, I want to have sex with myself. There's one.
Okay. That was an event there.
That was a team play.
Was I gonna say? But yeah, like me, I couldn't cheat. Like just the emotional fucking shit that I would have from doing it would be absolutely unbearable.
I've thought about it, and like if you're drunk, if it was just like one really bad night of passion kind of thing, I think there's a realm where I could get it. I think I could forgive that. Like, if it was just this, I made this one really shitty mistake. It was just more like lust than anything else. You know what I mean? If someone is out there banging his secretary every night, that there's clearly the relationship's not working anymore.
Yeah, you know, maybe if it's a mistake or something, I can understand, but. Even mistakes, though.
I've never had anyone cheat on me, so I don't know how I would react. But trying to imagine it, that's what I would think. Is it like, it kind of depends on like one really bad mistake versus just, you know, there's no like love there anymore. So
I had someone cheat on me, but it was like a minor, and also like
it was a minor. Jesus.
Yeah. Well, we were both minors at the time, so.
What the? Fucking! I didn't know you worked in a mine.
Yeah.
At your
Bitcoin
age,
mining.
In this guy, a miner. You cheated on me with a Bitcoin miner.
Yeah. The device, not the person.
Uh-huh.
Oh. But like, she just like kissed somebody. And we were also like the relationship just wasn't going anywhere.
Yeah, see, there's a difference between like a lustful mistake or like drunken mistake and someone like making a decision because they're unhappy. And at that point, it wouldn't even be like I'm trying to punish you as much as just I need to like move on for my own sake.
Yeah, I don't. This was a drunk thing, but it was like. You know, as I was analyzing it, it was basically like, yeah, this isn't working out, though, so.
Yeah.
I'm mad that it happened, but I'm more like, well, I guess that's how it goes. Like, I guess this is how it ends.
People cheat all the time. It's just a thing at this point.
Yeah, I remember, there was the time, Gary was like, so Gary Kristen's ex-husband.
Uh-huh.
Right, he was like, yeah, everyone cheats. Like, he was trying to convince, I think, either trying to convince Kristen or somebody to have like an open relationship. And so he's like talking about it, and he's like, yeah, everyone cheats. Everyone in every relationship cheats.
Oh my God.
Like, that is not true.
Is that one of those typical, like, even looking at a woman lustfully means you've already slept with her, as far as sin is concerned?
He's just trying to. Actually, I gotta pee.
Okay. Let's go be.
I'll
perverts
tell you. I'll finish it. When
let's
I
go
get
be
back.
Perverts in the bathroom together.
I'm back.
Hello.
So with the Gary thing though,
that was just real quick. I wanted to acknowledge that the exact same thing I was gonna say, Angel. Is it like it's such a horrible thing that like if the relationship's not working, fucking leave. Don't cheat. That's such a shitty thing. But I think a lot of people just get stuck. They're just like, it's so easy to just be in this relationship, but I want something on the side that's fun. But I don't want to abandon what I'm already got, kind of thing. I think that's a lot of it.
There's that. There's also the fact that people sometimes, you know, they don't realize they're not happy in the relationship until they cheat.
Mm-hmm.
They kind of think, oh shit.
So you're talking about Gary.
Yeah. So he was like, yeah, everyone cheats in a relationship. So humans aren't built for monogamous relationships. I'm like, that's not. Humans are highly complex, dude. You can't say that every single human isn't built for monogamous relationships, and that every single relationship. I was like, hey, are you literally saying every single? He's like, yes, every single one. I was like, well, I know that's not true, because I was in relationships, and we didn't cheat on each other.
When you can personally be a representation against an argument, it's kind of hilarious.
He's like, no, then they cheated without you knowing. I was
also,
like, no.
If you made like some kind of evolutionary argument that like humans aren't built for it or whatever, who says we can't fuck with our biology? Who says we can't overcome it? You know, we overcome nature all the goddamn time. We made wolves into dogs. We turned bananas into what they are. You know, like. Even if that was a thing,
we put plastic in our asses. Like
that is a thing we do. Yeah, that is. But that's not against nature. That's how nature intended.
Oh, nature intended for plastic. That
I mean,
plastic didn't exist. But
I know it's fucked up to talk about. But back in the day, you got your cavemen and shit. They just raped a bunch. Most likely, yeah. Like there wasn't the social construct of like and don't do that,
and it wasn't really rape either. It was like, you know what I mean? Like it potentially didn't necessarily cause psychological harm to people because that's the way it was.
Yeah, I don't even know how to begin to say like what that should be called. But
it's like, there's no,
damn,
like there's no, there was no concept of consent to begin with. Right, not saying that like it's morally acceptable,
yeah,
but at the same time we didn't really have morals back then.
Kind of just how things were, because you know they didn't have like age of consent back then for sure. Like as sad as it is, that was not a thing.
And also we can psychologically evolve too, not like fully to, you know, make it so.
We're not out here raping like our ancestors were, so clearly, even if you had a solid argument about cheating, it doesn't even matter.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm sure guys were fucking anything that moved at that point.
Oh, that.
I'm trying to spread my genes, so you know your whole argument about cheating back then, sure.
Trying to open my jeans.
Fucking anything that looked good.
Oh fuck, I suck. Oh, that's fine. Shoot it. Purge yourself. Hey. Gwen. Yep!
Ooh, nice.
Yeah, I wasn't sure. And I was like, good, I can steal this from him.
I wasn't sure either. I probably was, but you reassured me. B,
Yeah. So, you know, what's scary is that there's really nothing stopping us from returning to something as fucked up as that either.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, not in our lifetime, so, like, as a species, it's whatever, but, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but I'm just saying that, like, it's our culture that has prevented us from acting like that.
Yeah.
You know, if there was a change in culture again, like, you know, God forbid a fucking Muslim state. What is that called? Sharia law?
Yeah.
You know, that's some fucked up shit. Where there has to be, like, a certain number of witnesses to a rape before it counts. Speaking of which,
nope.
I listened to
DNA evidence. Nope.
Listened to a podcast about Jehovah's Witnesses. I was getting wanting to talk about that.
Real quick. Oh, what the fuck?
You left the match. Yeah, we can connect. I'll go into my Jehovah's Witness thing in a minute. We can.
What the fuck? It appears you accidentally. Would you like to rejoin? Yeah.
Oh fuck.
What the fuck just happened? What? And my screen just went black, and all of a sudden I'm out of the match.
No.
And my internet was fine. Like I had. I didn't drop any frames or anything. But what I was gonna say about Gary is, like, that was a time where he said literally everyone, you know, cheats, and I was like, you can't logically even prove that. Like, and he said, yeah, I can. I was like,
unless you redefine what cheat means, that's such bullshit.
Yeah, and he said, well, then by what you're saying, you can't prove anything. I was like, oh, are you gonna fucking do this? But I said, I think therefore I am, and that. That means I did prove something, and therefore your 100% skepticism is stupid.
Yeah.
And he's like, he just quit. But he was also partially drunk.
Still kind of sticks up after all.
He left. I wonder if he fucked up too, like I did.
Yeah, I can't imagine he would leave a match that he's winning 5 seconds before it ends.
Oh my god!
No, I was trying
not like that
to stop
though.
That. I was really.
Yeah, he rejoined the match. Fuck's sake. There's one guy on the other team.
Am I next?
1300.
Am I the next victim of the darkness? Or are we gonna win? Well, how great would it have been if I just died right before your call?
So that guy going for it, I was like, nope. Oh, he wasn't gonna reach it.
I got MVP. I was shit though. You must have been real bad.
Well, considering I left partway through the match.
Oh, that's right.
And my points reset to zero.
You guys had your points. That's the easiest MVP I've ever gotten.
I had 400 points after I got reset. I think I'm pretty good.
I don't know what you're talking about. I got MVP. Oh man.
Though one of those goals really belongs to teammates. Oh yeah, I was going to say something about the spread your seed thing. I was going to make a joke, but then I didn't. So, well, you're going to say about Jehovah's Witnesses? Remember?
Yeah.
Oh.
Am I just a fucking dancing monkey? I'm just supposed to talk whenever you want me to.
No, the match was starting and you weren't saying anything.
I already told you that I don't dance.
Oh, I don't have regenerative boost. I forgot.
Oh, come on.
Oh, God, I'm... Yep. What a stupid hit. Be on the replay. Yep. No! Fuck!
I was kind of hoping Angel would be back, because this is going to be... Oh, there she is. If you don't dance, you're no friend of mine. So, oh my god. I listened to a podcast about Jehovah's Witnesses, and I didn't know a whole lot about them, but man, they are super culty. Oh god. they just like have all these things that they repeat back and shit, and like just canned lines that they're supposed to say every time. Women aren't allowed to. They follow the Bible like very closely. Like they're not allowed to have women teach things. Like women aren't even allowed to like preach and shit. If there's men in the room, because like women aren't allowed to teach men things. And if they're praying over someone, they have to have their head covered. He told a story about how she was praying over this 9-year-old kid, and she
117 by the way.
She put a napkin on his head, on her head, because you have to have your head covered.
Wow.
Some shit. They're not allowed to vote, which I thought was interesting. They're not supposed to influence like worldly things. Never wow. seen a female Jehovah's Witness. Because apparently they used to, and it's crazy that they're not allowed to. They're not allowed to vote and have any kind of representation in politics, and yet they're forced to abide by the law to the letter.
Oh, yeah.
Like they pay their taxes and shit because they're supposed to. But anyways. Yes! No! They used to make fun of Catholics for having excommunications. They used to say, like, what kind of church is gonna like kick people out? That's clearly just you trying to cover something up or hide something. That was insane in the membrane. But they used to make fun of that, like back in the 1950s. They used to make fun of the Catholic Church for that. But now they do it. They just call it something different. It's called I always get like Mormon and Jehovah's Witnesses confused. But they will do the thing where no one will talk with you that's from the church, including your own family. They all just like pretend like you don't even exist. And so there's all these really sad stories about families that are torn apart because one person did something they weren't supposed to. You know, if you went out and voted for Bernie Sanders, you could be cut off from your family. Like your family just will stop talking to you entirely. And like I said, they follow the letter of the law very closely from the Bible. And the Bible also has something about if a woman is raped and they're in a town and nobody hears her screaming, then the rapist is put to death, and she is also put to death because she didn't scream loudly enough. Which I guess implies that, like, she kind of wanted it. Like, if you didn't want it, you would have screamed louder, kind of thing. That's the only thing I can imagine. That's because it's like, but if they're out in the country, then it's okay because, you know,
what?
She could have been screaming really loudly and no one just heard her. Is like the difference.
I iced him and it just launched the ball off of him like super fast.
And then there has to be two witnesses to any crime. So if you just go and report he raped me, if he doesn't back you up, then too bad.
See, those rules are just absolutely just dumb. Don't make sense.
It's how you know it was written by humans, because they're stupid and short-sighted and like super male-oriented. Because even the phrasing is like, if a man rapes a woman that is betrothed to someone else, he's put to death because he took someone else's property, basically. It's the wording. It's like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
You've ruined my property. She's worthless now. She's been raped. What am I supposed to do with this now? And so apparently there's a whole bunch of
oh god,
there's a whole bunch of pedophilia that is just swept under the rug because of this law, or because, like, no one goes to the authorities, they go to the elders, who are considered to have all the wisdom and stuff. And so if they don't, and here's the really sad thing, these fuckers will, like, question you about what happened when you tell them about it. They'll ask super personal questions, and they want all kinds of details. They gave a story about a guy who he performed oral sex on his wife, even though he knew he wasn't allowed to. That's, for some reason, that's a no-no. If it's not missionary for the purposes of procreation, it's not good. But so he was like, okay, honey, don't tell anyone about this, but I want to do this for you. She felt so bad about it afterwards that she reported him to the elders, and then they asked him for all sorts of information. They asked him, like, what position were you in? What position was she in? Like, how long did you do it? Were you on the bed? Like, they're basically, like, just taking down notes. They're, like, writing the pornography that these people are detailing to them. And yeah, the dude got, like, it's not disenfranchised, it's dismembered ships or something like that. I can't remember the damn word now, but same thing goes for the underage rapes. Imagine you're a 15-year-old girl and the guy that everyone tells you is, like, this is the elder of our community. He is like the pillar. This guy can do no wrong. This guy speaks for God. And then the dude, like, you know, does some horrible shit to you. And even if you want to report him, you have to now go up in front of, like, a couple of 60-year-old, like, assholes that are going to ask you a bunch of questions. They're going to make you, like, relive the entire thing in detail to them. This is a real thing. This sounds like some bullshit from, like, the 1800s, but there's, like, 8 million Jehovah's Witnesses out there. And because there's such, like, a closed circuit kind of, like, community of themselves, they get a wide berth. No one really fucks with them, and they like handle all their own shit internally. And of course the people that get out are like, yeah, this stuff's real messed up. Same thing with Mormons. That's why r/ex-Mormon and r/ex-Jehovah's Witness are, like, huge subreddits of people talking about how they finally got out and how much greater their life is. I did not know all that stuff about them. I thought they were pretty harmless. I thought they were just the obnoxious people that'll knock on your door, but my god.
No!
So yeah, I just wanted to depress you guys with that little tidbit I learned today. I was indoctrinated as a kid, but man, it could have been a lot worse. there's a lot worse religions out there.
Oh shit! Fuck!
Yeah, I mean, if you met Jehovah's Witnesses, they'd probably be, like, the guy said, they're, like, real salt of the earth people, they're real nice. Oh, I was gonna crush that. But, you know, there's, it's what that kind of community will foster is what's scary about it. Of like, the second anyone comes up with a complaint, we excommunicate them. If you don't allow for people to criticize, then things don't improve. Even though you had piercing, yeah, I mean, that's the sad thing about religion, is that so many of the people are like more moral than their own religion. You know, like when they hear bad shit in their holy book, they justify it. They try to squeeze around it because they know it's horrifying. It's shitty. So they're like, well, maybe it's just a bad interpretation. You know, that can't be right.
Oh shit! Oh, Stan!
I think a large majority of. Oh my god. I think a large majority of people. Because I know I did it. I tried to justify that kind of shit. Like, Bible just literally says, here's how you buy and sell slaves. Here's how to do it. Here's what I'm gonna allow you to do. Like, how do you justify that? But people do it, they find ways. They're like, yeah, the Bible says it's okay to buy slaves, but if God had written a book that said you can't buy slaves, if he'd forbidden it, then people wouldn't have taken it seriously because they loved their slaves. So he had to come up with like a halfway compromise so that they would be like, all right, well, he's not saying we have to get rid of them. He's just saying we have to treat them better. So that's why God didn't put "don't have slavery." Like, you know, maybe in the Ten Commandments, the one where like three of the ten are all about how to worship Him, and not a single one says "don't rape" or "don't have slaves." Just kind of forgot those in the ten most important rules. Oh no.
Oh, about time they put one in.
I watched the first two episodes of My Hero Academia.
Oh yeah?
I actually like All Might when he's drained and deflated.
Yeah, he's cool. He looks cool.
That's a neat. First of all, it's a neat concept that the guy that's supposed to be Superman is actually like struggling. Stan, blessed be.
And we are kicking ass in that match.
So yeah, it's a cool concept to have him
start was bad. And
I don't remember how the game started out. So
beginning of the match. You like the concept though of like him only having powers for a limited amount
like
of time.
Like he's basically One Punch Man for the rest of the time, but then he's just like, ah shit, all my surgeries and stuff, I have to I resort back to barely being able to walk up the stairs is interesting. And then and then just like his design is really neat. Not the biggest fan of the main character. It's just I've seen it, you know, you've seen that kind of character everywhere. It's
what
pretty
kind of character?
The character that's like, I want thing, but people tell me I can't have or do thing, so I'm gonna do it anyways.
I mean, that's most of them.
I know.
Just kind of media.
That's what I hate. I hate that I've seen it a million times. I mean, it's not enough to like ruin the show for me. I didn't like Naruto, but I liked the show.
Just
if you want my thoughts, I'll give them to you.
Oh no, I'll take it.
The fire hose guy is awesome. Backdraft. I never would have thought like a superhero built around being a fireman would be cool, but I love him with his little garden hose, his fire hose arms was kind of cool.
I forgot about the guy. He just never comes up.
Oh yeah, I didn't think he was like an important character. I was just saying like I've only seen two episodes. I can only comment on what I've seen.
Yeah. No, I'm gonna say like I fucked that.
I'm watching Crunchyroll, and I didn't see dubbed, so I'm watching subs, and the my ad block is awesome because I didn't see a single ad. I'm just getting like full HD, no ads, no problem. So it's just like kind of a perfect experience for me. But yeah, so I'm watching subs, and then the really gigantic lady, the rookie hero,
Miss Mountain or something.
Yeah,
like
Miss
that.
Mountain or something. She shows up and it had like some really cheesy pun about like
I don't have boost.
Damn it! I really wanted to remember the pun I was gonna tell you, but she's like poking her ass out, and it had some kind of pun about butts. And like her first, it was like, this is my first appearance. I don't remember. Fuck it. I was gonna try to figure one out, but that was really silly. And of course the antagonist so far is really cliche too. He's got a cool power because it's explosions from his hands, but he's just like Draco Malfoy from Harry Potter or every other bad guy bully that's like,
fuck you, main character. I don't like you because you're the main character.
He's not the antagonist, but yeah.
He is right now.
He's the rival character, is what he is.
Yeah. I mean, he's being antagonistic at the moment. I didn't think he'd be the main antagonist, but again, I'm going off the two episodes I've seen.
Yeah.
Forfeit with 3 minutes and 17 seconds.
In a rumble match. Fuck you.
So yeah, the slime monster really surprised me.
What a save.
The slime monster you slammed it into the wall, my man. You centered it for them. I don't know why you're complaining to us. Oh boy. You know what? I think I'll report him. Cause
wow.
Fuck you. That's why. Oh yeah. Commends? Do we have a commend system now?
Oh, he said the N-word there, Angel.
Man, fuck this guy.
Jesus Christ.
He also put it in all caps, which is kind of hilarious.
Yeah, and you get banned from that. Like, they have a text filter that if you report them, they will be banned.
Oh, yeah. I can't wait to get my message where it says, the person you reported got banned. Thanks for your help. I'm looking forward to it. So fuck you.
Oh, look at this. Me saving it.
I don't want us to win now. I want him to suffer. Especially because he was saying what a save when it was his fault that we got scored on.
Yeah. So
and look at that. It's Stan on the other side, too.
Yeah. Yeah, Stan was the one who said that shit. To the how are those commends coming?
Do we have like a commend option?
I don't even know what a.
I remember them talking about that, where it was like people that are friendly, you can give them like a commendation, and then when you rack those up, like they would get a reward or something.
It's in Overwatch. So...
Yeah, it's a really cool thing. I remember them talking about it. I remember Psyonix talking about it, so I was like, if that's in there, that's neat. Like I'd probably give Stan one. He was a cool guy.
Yeah, you know, some of the characters have some cliche stuff, but like the characters do grow as the time goes on. They don't.
Yeah, I'm not like bailing on it after two episodes. I'm gonna give it its fair shot. And you know the idea of the idea of people just gaining superpowers. You know, it's X-Men, so I'm into X-Men.
Yeah.
It was weird that All Might kept saying American cities with his attacks, but you know, superheroes is a very American thing. That started here.
Well, he's American.
Oh, okay. Well, that makes sense.
For two, he's also drawn in the American comic book style.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he has that shading on his face.
I could tell. And that's what I was saying is like, comic books are American superheroes. That's an American thing.
I didn't get a pass, damn it. I was magneting it. Oh shit. Yeah.
It's so cool that when you report someone it shows the text messages that will be sent to Psyonix.
That's
exactly why I wanted to report right there.
I hit text harassment. Was there a better one I could have selected?
I didn't even look at the drop down menu because I thought that was spot on. What I wanted.
I don't remember seeing the exact messages that transpired, but I was trying to get back to the match real fast. Oh, I was trying to shoot at the other guy.
Yeah. Fuck you. Don't give me a nice shot, you piece of shit.
Hey, you're an idiot.
You're a garbage human being.
Fucking.
And you know, we've been down this road before, but saying the N-word doesn't make you a garbage piece of human being. You know, if there's
the
context for it, yeah.
And he's using it as an insult.
Sure is. He's using it because he knows it's an edgy insult to say.
Yep. And what's really dumb is like you get banned for that shit. Yeah. Why? Why would you do that?
I'm surprised it doesn't just auto-censor that. They auto-censor our team names and shit, or like they won't let you pick team names. I'm kind of surprised they'll even let you see those letters in that.
Yeah, I wonder if it's because it was... Nah, it shouldn't be because it was part of, like, ass. So I don't know.
I mean, they can still...
Oh, no, I know.
Yeah.
It's just sometimes their systems aren't robust enough, but theirs is in this game. I know it is.
Yeah, that's the other thing, Angel. He put ass in front of it. Which is just fucking stupid. And it was like one word. There was no space in between. He didn't have time for spaces. That guy's got a cool car.
He was so pissed that I called him out. Oh, good. Lost my champ status. That's great. There goes my champ. Yeah, I really like All Might. He is my favorite. Right now, he is like one of my favorite characters in anime. He's great.
I haven't watched long enough to pick a favorite. I know the cute engineer girl. I'm really looking forward to her. I know I'm gonna like her, but I'm sure I'll settle on a favorite at some point.
Well, I'll tell you right now, she's only in like a couple episodes.
No, I know. I know that. I know she's not a main character. It's fine.
But no, she's fine. There's a lot of cute girls on the show. There's a lot of cute ones.
Oh, good. Then I'll keep watching.
They're fun. But I don't remember exactly. So what happened in the first two episodes? I know
there was a slime monster.
Ka-chan got slimed.
Yeah, that it was like going straight down his throat. I was like, whoa, shit. Am I watching the hentai version? What the hell?
Yeah.
And All Might saves him, puts him in like a 2-liter bottle, which was hilarious.
Yeah.
And was like, I gotta get this back to, I gotta, you know, throw this guy in jail. And then main character grabs onto his leg as he jumps away because he's like, I've been wanting to ask you questions. You're my hero.
As he's basically flying away.
Yeah, and that
he wasn't flying.
That's how he drops the, the jug, and the slime monster gets away, and then wraps itself around his rival later on, and is like trying to take him.
Right.
And All Might has to blast him away a second time. He has to like seeing you charge into battle, even though you don't even have a power. I do like that they call him quirks. That's a really cool word for it. Seeing you charge in there without a quirk gave me the motivation to unleash my Hulk again and save the day.
Yeah.
Man, I really wish anime would stop using flashbacks so much. And it's like, you're giving me, you're repeating dialogue that I heard this episode. I haven't forgotten. I'm paying attention.
Yeah.
I mean, I understand it's like it's telling you what he's going through his head right now, but you don't have to treat me like I'm an idiot. I know that he's remembering back to when his mom said, when he asked his mom, can I still be a hero even though I don't have a power?
Yeah.
And what obviously I know he's going to get a power.
What happened in the second episode?
I think that was the second episode. Episode.
I thought the first episode was the slime men, and then the second episode was something else. Because the first episode, that's how what got me pumped on the show was like, shit, I fucking love All Might with his fucking Detroit Smash or whatever. It sounds so dumb as a name, but when he does it in the show with this Japanese voice, I'm just like, oh, he sounds so cool. I love this guy. Also because it's just Big Punch.
I think that was the second episode. Because it ends with... Because All Might tells him, like, this is probably like a 2-episode arc, actually.
It might be.
Because All Might tells him in his deflated form, he's like, I'm not going to tell you you can be a hero without a quirk. Like, we risk our lives constantly, and you gotta have like a realistic outlook. You can't fight the kind of shit that we fight without even having powers. He tells him to be a cop. He's like, you can be a cop and help people. You don't have to have powers to help people. Which I actually kind of agree with. Like, if you don't have a superpower, you should not be fighting other superpowered humans. And there's plenty of other professions, like being a doctor or a nurse or a cop or a fucking librarian. There's plenty of ways to help people that don't involve running headlong into battle.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
you know,
I think
he is going to get a power, so that's going to make more sense.
I think the whole getting the slime monster the first episode and the second episode was like him getting out or whatever.
Yeah.
So
Because the second episode ends with All Might saving his rival buddy with the explosive fists.
Yeah.
Which is very similar to Roy Mustang in Full Metal with his... But he had to snap to make the explosions happen.
Yeah.
Which was so
cool. I like how they explain the powers, too, a lot of the times. They explain later why, like... They give you properties of how the powers work. It's not just explosion. But, like... The explosion guy, his sweat can explode. His sweat is explosive, and he can ignite it.
That's cool. Because that was going to be one of the things I said, was that I love the powers in Full Metal Alchemist because they've got a really nice, strict rule set. It's all about transmutation and like equivalent exchange and stuff. And in this one, I was going to say, like, people just randomly get crazy shit and like none of it's really connected, just everyone just gets something. But then he goes to the doctor and they're like, well, we noticed that people who don't have a second joint in their pinky toe tend to have quirks, and you got the second joint, so you're probably not going to have a quirk, and most people present with it before they're 4 years old anyways. Yeah. And he actually asked, like, what powers did your parents have? Like, she has a small, like, telekinesis, and she's like...
Shitty telekinesis.
Yeah. And my husband could, like, breathe fire or something. He's like, well, we would have expected a manifestation of one or both, like, a combination of those things. Like, oh, I was like, cool, so there's, like, a hereditary kind of component to it. That's neat. It's not just... Like, because that's how it works in X-Men, is, like, one person might get wings, another person controls the weather, and it doesn't matter if your parents were mutants. There's just... It's just kind of magic that just happens. Just some people get magic and some don't. Which is, it's fine, but it's I appreciate some kind of rule structure more, and they're laying the groundwork for that, which is cool.
Yeah, there's definitely a rule structure, and, like, you know, each person has flaws and shit like that.
And just in general, I'm interested in a high budget Japanese take on superheroes. Like, I've seen an American superhero stuff a million times since I was a wee bab, so it's cool. Yeah, we talked about this in quite a lot of detail, Angel, but we talked about how rules are make or break things, because if you don't have a good set of rules, then the writers just get you out of any situation, or get you into any situation, or, like, one person will be, like, really powerful, and then it's like, well, we want this new villain to seem badass, so we're just gonna have this person forget that they have these powers, or their powers aren't gonna work like they usually do, just because that's what the writer wants for this episode. It's so much better when the writer feels like they're hemmed in by the rule system that they've made. It's so much more interesting.
Yeah, random.
Yeah, instead of random funny, random cool. And
that's what Doctor Who always felt like to me.
Oh, yeah.
Was just no rule set. He just pulls something out of his ass, and he wins.
I really liked the 11th Doctor. I watched a couple of those seasons, but even then, I was like, God, it's just everything changes from one episode to another, and it's just no. And I stopped watching Dragon Ball Z because I felt like it was just, we've decided this character has a higher power number now. Like,
yeah.
Okay, I'm good, thanks. Early Naruto, when Shuriken and Kunai actually mattered and they were doing shadow jutsu shit, and, like, I threw this windmill shuriken and you caught it, but there was a second one hiding underneath that one's shadow, and then, like, oh, you dodged that one, but that was actually Naruto doing a transformation jutsu. Now he's going to throw a kunai at you from behind. Oh, but you blocked that, but that was actually still part of our plan. It was just like, I love that kind of shit.
Yep.
And
that's, yeah, you know, My Hero Academia does that a lot too, which is nice.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm here for. I was hoping with the slime monster, because, like, the wood guy is kind of neat. I don't know if that's going to be a character going forward, but there's a dude who just, like,
a little bit
has, like, wood coming out of his hands, and he's like, well, I can't get close because there's fire everywhere. I'm just going to catch on fire. The fire hose dude is like, I'm putting fires out, so I can't really help. There's one dude who's just like, I punch real hard, but it doesn't help to punch slime. That's not doing us any good. So they were all like, we're kind of useless in this fight. We need someone else, you know, obviously All Might, to come in and save the day. What I thought would have been cool is if the main character came up and, like, worked some kind of neat strategy or tactician kind of stuff, because he's taking notes and writing weaknesses and stuff in his little notebook. I was like, that's really neat. That's exactly what I would do. That's one of the reasons I like The Witcher so much, is it's like, here's a monster, here's what it does, here's its weaknesses, here's some lore about it. I was like, I thought it'd be really cool if he, like, put that stuff to good use, but he's mostly just kind of, I'm the main character, I'm going to run at it, and I don't have a plan, but I've got courage. Courage is my power.
Yeah.
But, you know.
That's only for the first episode, though, luckily. Or maybe a couple episodes. He really does think situation. He's like, he is the tactician.
Yeah.
He does, like, analyze stuff. It'll go inside of his head, and he'll be like, oh, well, this, he does this, and he does this, and so I gotta counter with this. No. Like, he'll debate with himself in his head and shit.
Gotta get through the early stuff, and you know, to be fair, it's a lot of it's cliche, but you want your initial episodes to cast a wide net. You want to catch a lot of people. You're gonna have some of the flashy stuff, and you gotta set the foundation stuff. I understand. I'll keep watching.
The thing is, though, is, like, a lot of the stuff, it sounds cliche in terms of characters, maybe, but in terms of shonen anime, it's also not very cliche. Because, like, a lot of shonen anime is literally pull stuff out of your ass, power levels higher than other power levels, a bit like that. Right? Yu-Gi-Oh, right? Yu-Gi-Oh seems like it has a strategy, but it's literally just, I pulled the right card at the right time because the universe says so. Right? And so it's nice to actually have also a main character that's not an idiot. It's nice to have, because shonen animes are known for that. Main character's a complete idiot and just fumbles through everything.
That's what we have currently, but I'm sure he'll get better over time.
Yeah. It's not even over time. Like, pretty much right away, he gets better.
That's good.
So, it's...
Because, I mean, right now, we pretty much just have... All Might has solved, like, every problem by punching real hard. And that's fine, because I know what they're doing. They're setting up who All Might is, and you know, they're making him more interesting than just Japanese Superman. He's got, like, things he's dealing with. Like, he actually wants to be a hero, but now he's got all these like physical ailments and shit that he's dealing with. So that's cool. Yeah. There's things I like in here. There's some morsels to chew on that I'm enjoying.
Yeah. And when villains come up too, that's really good, because obviously there's going to be villains.
It's probably not something I would have picked up on my own and gone through, but I've also just seen so much support for it on Reddit as well, that community is enormous, and they're deeply in love with it. So I imagine it won't take me long, and I'll be just as hooked as any other show.
Yeah.
That I like. I'm sure I'll be coming in here going, oh my god, I wish I'd watched it sooner. I'm sure it's just a matter of time. I avoided One Punch Man for the longest time. Thought that sounded stupid as hell. Now it's one of my favorites.
I might watch One Punch. It's not one of my favorites, but I definitely like enjoy watching it.
That was a really funny One Punch Man gif you gave me. That was great.
Oh yeah, the May one.
Yeah, I wouldn't have gotten it if we weren't specifically talking about the May video.
Let me tell you real quick. May not only does it appeal to me with, like, the cute girl doing cute actions, the sexy stuff, like, while sexy stuff is hot and everything, I don't really care. It's just kind of there for me.
I like
Like, because if I'm going to watch sexy stuff, I'm just gonna watch porn. I don't think it's bad to be in there, and I think it's artistically good in there, but it's not giving me a boner, is what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
But the
animation is incredible.
The animation is so top-notch. Great. And the song and the like different stages it goes through and stuff like that. The thing, but also. That visual style with, like, the vector art that they have going on with, like when Mame, you know how it says the One Punch Man gif, right? And they have it spell out One Punch Man.
Mm-hmm.
That's all, like, vector art animation stuff. Yeah. And with the colors and whatnot, that sort of visual style very much appeals to me. So not only is it just all those other things, but also just, like, the way it presents its art just really appeals to me. So
I'm never a big fan of, like, crazy fever dream shit where you don't know what the hell is happening, where just things are, like, morphing constantly one into another. Like, there's a lot of that video where I'm following along and I'm enjoying it and stuff, and I think this one does it, like, way better than most. But when you're just seeing, like, weird shapes transforming into other shit, I don't care for that.
Right, yeah, it was...
I can't understand, like, what I'm looking at anymore.
Some of the shapes, though, there was some, like, this is a heart morphing into a vagina, morphing into other stuff. So, you know, there was some, like, symbolism in there. But,
It's my least favorite way to do symbolism, is to just show you crazy fever dream colors.
Right.
That's just personal preference, though, I mean...
If it's vector art to my brain, I'm just sitting there going, ooh, colors and shit. And there's a music video that I'll show you once I put out my next electronic mixtape, which I think I need one more song. And there's a few music videos in there that have like a Vector R style, one particularly. And I can just sit there and stare at it. And there's no like meaning to the video. It's just shapes going on along with the music. But man, I could just stare at that like and be hypnotized. So, God, you know, it's official announcement here. May girl is second waifu.
Oh, I can't believe I was here for such a wonderful pronouncement. Aww.
Because she's so fucking cute, and I love her colors and her design and the way that she moves around in the video. Like, after I watched it the second time, and like some of those gifs, like the one where she's jumping with her hands behind her back and dancing, like, it's so fluid and looks so good.
Yeah, like I said, I'd love the animation.
Like, in the one where she's doing the whole, like, pointing to her head and then putting her hands down by her crotch thing is also mesmerizing with the fucking Vector Art Mei in the background, and ugh.
It really hit you in your sweet spot, didn't it? It just got all the things you like.
Yeah, so many things. Like, and when I remember, you know, it's on one of my mixtapes, and I love the song.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all three parts that I combined for the mixtape, because I didn't like it as three different songs. But like, I was like, I'll watch it again since we're talking about it, and I watched it again. I'm like, fucking shit, I love this. I forgot how much I love this, but I love this.
The gif where it goes to the guys dancing really got me. That crap.
Those Japanese guys, yeah. I was, because when you said, hey, let's just post a bunch of gifs, I was already looking for gifs before. So I was like just searching.
Let's rewatch it in gifs.
That's why I posted like four or five in a row, because I was like already in the middle of searching for them. And I found that one with the World Order guys.
I'm not
Rustin,
because I think she's adorable.
She's so awesome. Anyway, it's time to
good noodle
and switch noodle, son, bro. Have a good one.
Bye-bye.
Bye. I gotta switch over to Yakuza. I'll be back.